everybody. In today's video, I'm going to show you a design that really isn't very autumn feeling, but still it kind of goes into that. It's all greens. I personally love green. I think it's one of my favorite colors on my fingernails, and I always, whenever I'm wearing green nails, I always think of an episode of Craig Ferguson, his late night show that I saw so long ago, and I don't even remember who the actress was, but she had green nail polish on, and he said that he can always tell if a woman's crazy because she's wearing green nails, or if she's wearing green nails, he can tell she's crazy. That makes more sense. And ever since then, I've always thought, hey, I want to wear green nails. I always consider myself crazy, so it just seems appropriate. But anywho, I love this design. The leaves themselves are from Banggood, and I'm showing you a couple other things from Banggood. Some of the things from them, I'm going to say just off the bat, I didn't even open because the package was so, like, it exploded. So I was like, no, I'm not even going to make that mess. But you guys get to see it anyway, and I'll put links in the description box below. So if you want to, I actually really like the dried flowers I got from them. I think that they're a bit less fragile, actually, than some of them that I've gotten before, so that's a good thing. I hope you guys like it as much as I do, and don't forget to click subscribe, see all my future videos as well. Bye!
So the first way I'm going to show you is going to be the acrylic method. So you need cover pink, clear, white, and a milky white. So I'm first, just because my nail isn't as long as I want it to be, I'm going to sculpt it out a little bit longer with some clear acrylic. This is optional. If your nail is the length that you want it to be, you can skip this, or if you're going to apply a tip, like a glue-on plastic tip, then you can skip this step as well. But if you're going to be sculpting it like this, I'm going to just begin by creating a platform for the color with clear acrylic. Keep this incredibly thin because you don't want the whole nail to get super thick, and once you start creating your ombre, there's going to be a few layers, and so each one has to be relatively thin. And if you guys are curious, the majority of this video will be in real time. The only thing that isn't in real time is the hard gel version of this French ombre, and that's because honestly I'm super slow at hard gel, and so it would just take forever. But I'm going to clean up that free edge a little bit with the tip of my brush, kind of just scoop away the extra acrylic, press that out again. In general, I would say I'm a pretty slow sculptor, especially on myself. It's just the angle of it. And so I don't usually show things in real time just because the videos are very long. But with something that's this kind of in-depth and educational, I thought it would be helpful. So now I'm going to take white acrylic. This is the pure full white. And I'm going to press that down along the tip. As you can see, it isn't very much product. And then I'm going to gently brush it up. The fact that my nails are on the short side does make doing these ombres a little bit more difficult. But for a tutorial purpose, that's actually kind of nice because you get to see something that's harder than if this was a whole bunch of long nails, because it's easier to create that smooth blend because you have more space to do it on a long nail. So I'm going to fill in that one little area that just didn't have much for color and kind of blend that up again. I am being very cautious not to get any product on my skin. That is something that I honestly don't see that many nail techs do in videos. And I know that there are so many of you out there that are super cautious about not getting product on skin that it's kind of weird to me that so many people that are making tutorials aren't that careful. So the next color I'm using is going to be the cover pink, and I'm going to apply that to the cuticle area and then brush it down. So this acrylic that I'm using is actually kind of thin. So one thing that helps that prevents it from running into your cuticle is to tip your nail down a little bit, which is hard to do for the video, but if I were doing this not on camera, I would definitely angle my finger at like a 45 degree angle down towards the table. And that makes a huge difference and actually makes your blend go easier. The next layer of acrylic is going to be the milky white. And if you don't have a milky white, the best thing to do is to mix a 50-50 ratio of clear and white acrylic, preferably from the same brand, but that's not like the end all be all. But if you have the same brand, then that is a fantastic way to just make sure that your blend is going to be smooth. Usually it is anyway, but you know, extra precautions if you have them available. And so just mix a 50-50 and then test it and see how you like that pigmentation and then adjust from there. So I'm going to just apply that right in the fade area between the white and the pink and blend it both down over the white and then blend it up towards the pink. That's going to really create a nice blend. It's going to just further and make it more seamless. And then if you need to, you can either add more white or more cover pink. For me, I'm going to add just a touch more cover pink. Like I said, just, you know, kind of layering it until you're happy with the color combination. I personally prefer to do ombres with acrylic versus any other method, but I'm really used to using acrylic. So if you have a product that you're just used to using and you love, that's the one that you should practice on and do the most of, or whatever you use the most in your salon. So for the next one, I'm going to be doing, this is what I consider like the gel polish version. So you can do this on natural nails. You can do this over the top of an artificial nail if you want, but I'm first going to apply a layer of a semi-sheer nude gel color. And after I have that, I'm going to cure it and then use white gel paint, not gel polish, gel paint. I'm going to paint the tip. And you can use as much as you want and do like as far up the nail as you want. You can do just a thin little bit at the tip, however you want to do it. But then using a piece of cosmetic sponge, I'm going to tap, 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 and blend out that line. As you can see, this method is super fast. The whites is much more intense than sculpting it. And so you actually get some better color payoff. It blends out fairly easy, especially if you're using gel paint. So that's why that one is my second favorite. My third favorite is going to be using dipping powder. So this is another thing that if you're using and you do a lot of dipping powder in your salon or at home, either way, you can do this one and it's pretty quick and easy. So I'm going to start with gel base coat. And then after I have that, I'm going to do one quick dip into clear dipping powder. So this is a quick dip. Like I said, you don't want to have it linger in there. Everything is real time. I was waiting for my camera, I was focusing it. So just do a quick dip. And try not to, I lingered it too long. See, that's where part of my problem was, but I lingered it a little too long. Tap off the excess and you should be left with a little bit of a shine on the nail. So once the acrylic powder polymerizes with the gel base coat, it should have almost like a little bit of a shininess to it. And mine looks a little bit too powdery. So that's, you know, you may have to do a couple coats then if yours gets too powdery. But then bounce it into white powder so that you do more bouncing just on the tip, but kind of get some all the way like up to the 3/4 mark on your nail. And then just kind of keep tapping, 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 especially focusing on that tip. I know it's hard to see the angle I was doing it at, but then after you have that done, cure it just like it is. I know it doesn't look smooth, but cure it. After it's cured, then you can take a brush and you can brush it off and you should be left with a fairly nice smooth gradient. That one actually takes some practice. Well, they all do, so I don't know why, but that one, just something to keep in mind. The next one's my least favorite. This one is the sculpture gel, and you need the same colors as you needed for acrylic, a cover pink, bright white, milky white, and clear. And I'm going to begin filling in the product that's the cover pink color, just like the warm pink. And I'm going to just do a thin layer down the nail all the way down towards the tip. And you can do this either with that warm pink or you can use the clear. Either way, for this first coat, this is essentially the same process as what I did with the clear acrylic. I'm creating that platform on the tip of my nail, but because I am using this warm pink color, I'm also building up just a little bit of thickness in like the apex or the mid area of the nail so that I have a bit of a base color down. That is optional if you don't want to do that. Like I said, you could do just clear for this first layer, but then with some white builder or sculpture gel, and they're not the same, you guys, so just make sure that you know, like cure times and everything. What I'm using is sculpture gel, so it's a little bit, it holds its shape a little bit better than a builder gel. I'm going to apply that at the tip and then brush it up. For me, builder gel or hard gel, like I said in the beginning of the video, is just more tedious to work with. But if you're somebody that loves gel, I actually like the results from this nail the best. So it's one of those, you win some, you lose some. And then after you have the white done, then you're going to go through with your, it's either like a natural color or a milky white, depends on the brand, what they call it. So then you're going to take that intermediate color and you're going to apply it right in the middle. And then you're going to do the same thing, blending it up and blending it down. So both the acrylic and the hard gel techniques are actually like the same thing. You need the same colors and you need the same steps essentially to create the nail. So once you, you know, choose your route for which way you want to go, you just have to really practice it and, you know, figure out what to do for that particular type of product. So I'm going to keep working with this. Like I said, I don't work with hard gel nearly as often as I work with acrylic. So for me, this one just isn't as easy, which is why I didn't say it was my favorite. But as I mentioned, it's actually my favorite result. So you can go back and forth and like, I'm actually blending in just a touch of white into my natural color just so I can kind of intensify it a little bit and blending it as I go. The one good thing with a hard gel is that you can work on it as long as you want and you can really perfect your fade until you are happy with it. Once you're happy, cure it, and then I'm going to cap it with some clear builder gel. And so this layer is just to kind of smooth it out. And I think that clear encapsulation for both the acrylic and the hard gel helps to blend out your colors. It makes them just look a little smoother. And maybe I'm crazy and that's not the case, but to me, I feel like that really does. So like I did with the acrylic, you can go back and forth between, you know, your colors. The thing to keep in mind though with the hard gel is that you do have to cure it. And you have to cure it when the layers are getting too thick and also when you're switching colors. So you can't kind of just like go for it and just work on it till you're happy. You have to know that the layer might not look perfect, but you can perfect it later. So after it's all capped with clear and it's all ready to go, you can cleanse the nail and pop off the form. So just remove it from underneath. And then after these are all filed into shape, pretty much just the acrylic and the hard gel ones you're gonna have to file into shape, then you can finish the nail with a layer of gel top coat. And these are all done. As you can see, the effects on every one of them is a little bit different and they just have kind of a different vibe to them. So you have to decide what you like best visually and for working on it. And it's not necessarily the same nail. Like to actually like the ease of doing it, I would say the gel paint is the easiest way to do it, but I like the looks of either the acrylic or the hard gel better than those. So you have to find that balance for speed and results. So I hope you guys found this helpful, and here's a Melody Minutes.
We hope.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found some helpful hints out of this video. I know that something like this can be, it's seeming so simple, but then it's so complicated once you actually start doing it. So I hope it helped. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you next time. Bye.